Hello everyone, I am Dhyan and I am going to today show you some major parts in the braking system. So let's start with it. So there are two main sides in any braking system for an automobile. So the main side, the first of main side will be brake pedal assembly, and the other side is rotor assembly. So the brake pedal assembly is whatever we have close to the driver. The driver operates the brake, and whatever comes, which is things which are closer to that, that comes in brake pedal assembly. And the other part of the brake is in the tires or the wheel. So whatever assembly we need to do over there, that is called as the rotor assembly. So I'll explain about this brake pedal and rotors in subsequent slide, but this is the overall picture of how the braking system is looking like. So let's start from here. Here we have the brake pedal over where the driver is going to apply his force. So this is the hinge from where the brake pedal is pinned, and we can see that this is a bias made. So this is the advantage, mechanical advantage we are taking. So we are going to apply a force over here, and the opposite force is being applied to the fluid in the master cylinder over here. So this distance is larger, so we need to provide less force. And since this distance is smaller, the opposite equivalent force which will be applied will be much larger. The power brake system can be neglected right now. Then the force whichever we have applied using a piston assembly and the fluids which is there, that force is being applied on the fluid inside the master cylinder. We can have multiple master cylinder for front and rear. So this combination valve can be ignored if we have multiple master cylinders. And whatever force we have got from the inside the fluid, that the pressure has been increased in the fluid of the master cylinder, that pressure is being transmitted using these pipes. So these are called brake lines specifically. And the pressure inside the fluid gets transmitted to the brakes using a brake hose. And over here, there are multiple types of brakes which are shown. So in the front, we have disc brakes. In the rear, there are drum brakes. So the disc brake means that we have a disc attached to the tire, and we are going to that disc is going to rotate with the tire. So if we are going to clamp that disc using some force, that the tire is also going to stop. So in the first type, when we have disc brake, we have some disc, and then we are going to hold that disc using that force which we have applied. That force is being applied using a piston assembly. So whatever force we have, the pressure which is there inside the fluid, that is the brake oil, that piston, the piston is getting actuated using that pressure, and that piston is expanded using, and after the pressure which is applied by the driver, that contracts and it clamps on the disc. While in the opposite direction, in the other side, if we have drum brakes in the rear, if they are shown as drum brakes. So what happens is we have some drum kind of arrangement along with our tire. So, and inside the drum, we have some shoes, some pads like of arrangement. So when we are going to apply force, that the pressure is generated inside my brake line, that the oil applies force or the pressure onto my piston, and that piston is going to actuate the pad in such a way that the pad gets stick to the drum inside. Like if we have drum, circular drum like this, cylindrical drum, and my pad will be something like this, and it will get stick to that drum. So in that way, we are going to stop that weight. So generally in our automobiles right now, or whatever automobiles you would have seen in last 5 years, in the front wheels, we have generally the front disc brake, and in the rear wheels, we may have a drum brake or vice versa. Now let's come to major parts on pedal assembly. So I have explained earlier what was pedal assembly. Whatever which are the parts near to the driver, they are all assembled in some box type of arrangement, that is called as pedal assembly. So this was the pedal which I have shown earlier. So, and there can be two configurations for pedal. We can hinge the pedal from top, and the pedal can be in the opposite direction, which is shown in the here. So over here, the pedal is hinged from the top, and the pedal is hanging downside. While in our here, we have the pedal hinged from the bottom, and the pedal is upright. So it can have both the configuration, both are fine. And then this is showing two master cylinders. So there is some bias made, so we can have more pressure on the front and less pressure on the rear, or vice versa as per our need and as per the weight distribution. So if the weight is more on the rear side, we want more force on the rear side to stop that wheel. So we'll do some arrangement like this. We'll bias that such that there is more force applied on the rear side and less force applied on the front master cylinder. And hence the same pressure will be applied on that master cylinder fluid. That master cylinder pressure will be applied into the brake oil, and the same brake oil pressure will be transported to the pistons. So there are three kinds of pedal any engineer, brake engineer has to design. They are brake pedal, clutch pedal, and throttle pedal. And the brake pedal, we have already known, that is to stop the vehicle. Clutch pedal are required in IC engine type of automobiles, that is to change the gears. And the throttle pedal is the acceleration pedal. Whenever we want to do or give acceleration, that is the throttle pedal, that is the correct terminology. So it is ABC, acceleration pedal, brake pedal, and clutch pedal. Then we have master cylinder, which I have shown earlier, that is the reservoir in which the brake fluid is there. Then we have bias bar. The purpose of bias bar also I explained, that is to distribute or increase and decrease the amount of pressure we want to handle on the front and rear side. The return mechanism is an important one that is required, because when we are going to push that using the force, the driver is going to push, there should be some mechanism through which the brake pedal comes to its original position, and there are no brakes applied. So there is some spring type of arrangement or some hydraulic type of arrangement made such that the pedal comes to its original position. And the brake box or pedal plate is a plate kind of arrangement on which all the master cylinder, all my pedals are hinged or placed inside my vehicle. Now let's look at how the brake pedal and pedal assembly looks for an Formula SAE vehicle. So this is a image from FSAE electric vehicle pedal assembly from the team of University of Akron. So over here, since it is an electric vehicle, the clutch pedal is not required. So we have throttle pedal and brake pedal. So these are the pedals which are been noted. This some written arrangement is made, and this is the pedal plate on which all the parts are fixed. Now let's come to the arrangement which I have explained earlier. So let's look at it more in detail. So from here we were getting that force from the brake pedal. That brake pedal force is being biased. So this is where we are going to bias it. So we have some width already. So at the distance, if we are going to increase more distance from one of the side, let's say if we are in the middle, then the same force or the equal force will be applied on both the front and the rear side. But if you are going to move more on one side, then the force on the one side will increase and on the other side it will decrease. So that's how we are going to bias our pressure in the master cylinder. And this is the piston kind of arrangement, and this piston kind of arrangement is going to press the fluid inside this. So these are the master cylinders, and inside this the piston is going to increase the pressure, and the same pressure is being felt from the fluid which is going to come out. So here can be the exit line of that brake oil or brake fluid, and that is going to have increased pressure, and that same pressure will be transported from the master cylinder to the brake lines and to the piston, and the same pressure will be applied from the piston to the disc using the brake pad. Now let's come to the other side, that is the rotor assembly side. So we have known that how the pressure is being generated using the driver's force and how it is being transferred to the brake lines. Now let's come to rotor and brake caliper. These are the two major parts in the rotor assembly. One is the rotor, second is the brake caliper. So rotor is the brake disc or the disc which I have shown earlier. So this is called as the disc, and this is same as rotor which we have mentioned here. So these are the images from i10 vehicle of Hyundai. This is my own vehicle. So these are the brake disc in it, and they are mounted on a hub, and the hub is going to rotate with the wheel. Since the hub is going to rotate, the wheel is being attached from the four nuts or lug nuts which are shown here. The wheel is over here, the hub, the wheel is on the hub, and the brake disc is also on the hub. So the brake disc or the rotor is going to rotate with the wheel, and the brake caliper, or this is complete brake caliper, which is shown over here. So over here we have the brake line or the brake hose, from in which there is a brake oil or brake fluid, and the pressure is being generated inside that fluid, and the pressure gets transported, and we have pistons over here. So here it can be seen that we have two pistons. One piston will be lying over here and the second piston is lying over here. The back plate is just to hold the pistons. So we have pressure supplied on the both sides on the disc. So the piston gets contracted or expanded as per the arrangement made, and that pistons get forced onto the rotor. So the marks which you can see on my rotor, they are made because of the piston which is getting quickly clamped onto my rotor. And there will be pads on it. So that when the piston is going to contract or expand, there are pads. So the two pistons are over here. The pistons are going to make the force, and that pad is going to get clamped onto the rotor. And let's come to some other miscellaneous or smaller parts which are very important. So first is brake line, which I have mentioned earlier. This is how the brake lines are, and they have to transport huge amount of pressures of inside the brake fluid. So they are hosed, and there can be metal linings on it to make them stronger, and they do not get heated up due to some other parts if they are passing very close to engine. Then we have brake fluid or brake oil, to be more specific. So generally we use DOT3 or DOT4.4 oils. Then we have brake line or indicator lights, which you have already seen, and brake over travel switch. So brake over travel switch is some kind of arrangement, some kind of kill switch type of arrangement which is made. So if there is a panic and the driver is going to provide a very huge amount of force onto the brake pedal, the brake over travel switch is arranged in such a way that it will not let a huge force of that driver go onto the pedal. So this brake comes into the picture when the brakes are having a huge force on them or brakes are failed. So that's how we have the arrangement for BOT switch. It is called BOT switch. That's all we have. Thank you.